Hey guys, what's up? Smiley Face Gaming here, and today I'm going to be talking about what is CSGO and the basics of CSGO. So obviously this is a guide for players who are unranked on CSGO and have really never touched the competitive scene. If you already have a rank or have played competitive, there's another video that I think you guys would really, really help and really, really learn from, which will be in the description down below. It talks about how to perform better in CSGO competitive and things like that, so definitely go check that out. Link will be in the description down below. So without any more further interruptions, let's get on with the video. So the first thing I wanted to talk about was the bare basics of CSGO. Additionally, I have another video called Top 5 Buying Tips and Tricks, which tells you about what to buy on CSGO in pistol rounds and things like that. So if you're interested in that, definitely go check that out. There'll be a link in the description down below. Every single CSGO map consists of three main things: right, left, and middle. In this case, B is our right, middle is still our middle, and A is our left. Almost every single site, however, has multiple entrances. You can see it here on A, where you can go through palaces or T steps to get on A site from T spawn. The exact same thing still stands for counter terrorists. They can go right, middle, or left. In this case, right is middle, and B is still B. So that was just talking about the basic map layouts and how there are only three main routes to your enemy. Every single map is absolutely plastered with these little signs. They can tell you things like what different routes you can take to get to the different sites. There are a few different ways you can win rounds as a terrorist team on competitive matchmaking. The first of which is getting onto a site, planting the bomb, and letting it blow up. Once the bomb has been planted, the terrorist side will be gaining $300 per player. Once the bomb has been planted, the counter terrorists have only 35 seconds to get on site and defuse the bomb. Regardless of how many terrorist players are still alive, as long as the bomb explodes, the terrorists still win the round. The second way for a terrorist team to win the round is by eliminating all of the CT players. You can still plant the bomb even after killing all the players for an additional $300 per player. Next thing I wanted to talk about is how to win rounds on a CT side. There are three different ways to win rounds on the CT side, starting with killing all of the enemy terrorist players and then defusing the bomb. Upon defusing the bomb, every CT player will be receiving $300. The second and much more risky way of running around on CT side is known as ninja defusing. Ninja defusing is where you defuse the bomb as a CT player while there are still one or more terrorist players alive. This is typically done with a smoke and then multiple flashbangs so that the enemy cannot see you while you're defusing their bomb. Only use this strategy in extreme situations like a 1-on-3 or a 1-on-2 where you don't think that you can kill the enemy players and defuse the bomb. The third and final way of winning a CT round is by killing all of the terrorist players. So those were just the basics on how to win rounds as CT and T sides. The next thing I wanted to talk about was accuracy and your aiming on CSGO. If you would like to improve your accuracy on CSGO, follow these steps. The first thing you want to do is hit play in the top left corner and then head over to the workshop. Once you are there, hit view workshop, and then once the workshop is loaded up, search up aim_bots with a Z instead of an S at the end. You should see a map that says something like 2 million subs and aimbots on it. Click the subscribe button in the bottom right corner of the aimbots map and download it. Once you have subscribed to it and downloaded it, simply click the workshop, click the map, and hit start local server to start your very own aimbot server. Once you have loaded in, select the terrorist team and then proceed over to the fix/addbots button to fix all the bots and get the bots off of your team and all the bots onto the enemy team. Once you have done these steps, you can test out every gun in the game on bots, and you can even look at the spray patterns using the show impacts button. Every single gun in CSGO has its very own spray pattern. Starting with the AK, you can see it's kind of a backwards 7. Easiest way to control the spray without putting in a ton of hours into learning the spray is by starting the aim at his head and then aiming down towards his stomach. Exact same rule applies for the M4A4 and the M4A1S, where you just slightly pull down while spraying. The next thing I want to talk about is opping. With opping, once you scope in, the sights are still a little bit blurry, meaning that your bullet will be inaccurate. You can see this here as I line up on the dark spot, zoom in right away, and then shoot. But once I scope in for a while, wait a bit, and then shoot, the bullet is totally, completely on point. This means that the most effective way of opping is by waiting a second or two in between shots and scoping in to ensure that your bullet goes where your crosshair is. So if I were you, I would practice by getting 500 kills or so using a variety of weapons. Now before you're able to play competitive, you have to at least get to level 3 on CSGO. The easiest way to do this that provides the most practice is by playing Deathmatch. Deathmatch is essentially a brawl against the enemy team. After 10 minutes, the team with the most points, which are gained by getting kills, wins the game. there are no bombs in this game mode. Deathmatch is really, really good for getting up to level 3 and practicing your aim and getting kills and just seeing what CSGO is like. In my opinion, the best way to transition into the competitive scene is by playing Deathmatch until you are around level 2. Once you're at level 2 to 2.5, you can then consider going and playing Demolition or Casual game modes. When it comes to competitive, Demolition and Casual are much closer to it than Deathmatch. They both have a bomb and both are based off eliminations. So definitely go play those until you're about level 3 and then enjoy playing competitive. If you want tips on how to play competitive better, check out one of my videos that will be coming out actually later today. Thank you guys so much for watching, and this has been Spider Case Gaming, and I'll see you next time.